They called it their dream home. Now this couple picks up the pieces of what's left.
Everything is destroyed. Everything was destroyed.
Around 1 a.m. on December 11th, Munga Ramadani says the only warning came from his daughter, who woke him up because she was scared.
You were sleeping in here.
Yeah, I was sleeping. I didn't know anything.
You didn't hear anything?
No.
Then the tornado hit with wind speeds of 150 miles per hour.
Wood was falling on us.
As their home was ripped apart around them, Munga, his wife Sango Christina, and their 8 children managed to survive. They were screaming, crying, and praying.
I think God protect us because we pray a lot. That's why we are safe right now, me and my family.
Their neighborhood in Bowling Green, Kentucky, was among the hardest hit places by record-breaking tornadoes. 77 people lost their lives in the state. A 2.5-hour drive west of Bowling Green, the small town of Mayfield took a direct hit.
1 month removed from the historic tornadoes, Mayfield, Kentucky is block after block of nothing but rubble. And now the recovery effort underway, and among those helping out, the Catholic Church.
St. Joseph Catholic Church has become a bustling aid center.
Clothing, blankets, towels, sheets.
An overflow of donations from all over the country fill the parish hall, and all those who suffered in the storm can pick up what they need.
And some people, you know, they're impacted forever. It's going to take a long time to recover.
Jean Irwin lives in Houston, Texas, but she grew up in Mayfield and went to St. Joseph's. She came home for Christmas and decided to stay and volunteer at the church.
Someone is in need, so you help them. And there's a lot of people who are in need for a variety of reasons. Maybe they don't have a job now. Maybe they were impacted with their house.
In 2017, Jean lived through Hurricane Harvey in Houston. She says the destruction here is even worse, and parts of her hometown unrecognizable.
You don't know where you are because there's no landmarks. Everything's torn down or it's falling down.
The church bell tower was sheared off by devastating winds. But compared with other churches, businesses, and buildings along Broadway in the downtown area, St. Joseph's was mostly unscathed. That was not the case for Resurrection Catholic Church, about 70 miles away in Dawson Springs, Kentucky.
The altar was right here, and then we had our chairs over here against that wall there.
Father David Kennedy, the church pastor, remains optimistic despite the destruction.
The Lord will be pleased with what we do to restore this this church.
According to the mayor in Dawson Springs, the tornado destroyed 75% of this community. It's home to about 2,500 people. Father Kennedy says he has seen great charity at work within the town.
I think everybody has met a stranger or a neighbor who has helped them. I don't think there's anybody that's been left alone because of this tremendous amount of suffering and destruction.
And one Resurrection parishioner even opened their backyard storage shed as a temporary chapel for Mass to continue.
I broke into tears.
Father Kennedy says this space could be used for the next 2 years as they work to rebuild. The undamaged tabernacle and altar were recovered from the church and moved here after the storm. For those impacted by the tornadoes, it can be hard to make sense of it all. Years ago, Munga and his family fled suffering in the Democratic Republic of the Congo and lived in a refugee camp before finally immigrating to the U.S. and praying for a home of their own.
We feel God bless us because this was our blessing. We pray for so hard to get this house. We pray all the time before we get this house.
The family is still counting their blessings. Their home is gone, but their lives continue on. Munga points out where neighbors just a few houses down were killed in the storm. Father Kennedy says in times like these, Christians can offer their suffering to Christ's.
Reunite with Jesus on the cross with all our sufferings and unite to His.
And Catholics like Jean Irwin say living the faith means when other people suffer, it's time to step in.
It's my faith that tells me this is who I am and what I need to do.
Mark Irons, EWTN News In Depth.
Mark joins us now. What an incredible scene. Such devastation, Mark.
It was unbelievable.
What was it like for you going home, right? This is the same neighborhood just a few miles away from your home?
That's right. My home is a few miles away. My family and friends, thank God, were not impacted. But as you saw, the destruction, in particular in that neighborhood, was just, it was devastation. And I think the surreal thing walking through that neighborhood as you look at these images is that you could see the very defined path that this tornado made, the path of destruction. And the stark reality is there could be a home where people weren't impacted, where people survived, and then just a few feet away, a house moved off its foundation, destruction, and in some cases, people did not survive. So that's sort of the reality of these tornadoes, and to see it, yeah, it was shocking.
You never know who it's going to choose. You were explaining to me that there's also other tornado warnings other moments, but that this was different.
It's not uncommon in that part of the country, in Kentucky, to have severe weather come through. We have severe thunderstorms, tornado watches, and sometimes warnings. Even when I was home for Christmas, after these waves of storms went through, we had another tornado warning in Bowling Green that you probably didn't hear about. But the destruction was nothing like this. This is nothing short of historic.
So there's a long road to recovery.
That's right.
You were explaining to me that there's so much going on, neighbors helping neighbors, but also a big role that the church is taking.
That's right. Well, I just heard from the Diocese of Owensboro today. That was the diocese that was hardest hit. And between all the residents and businesses and church communities that they're helping, it's going to be about a four-year road to recovery, they said, at least. So this church in particular that we're looking at in Dawson Springs, the thing about this church is there was concerns after the destruction, would they even rebuild? Because it's a small community. There's 2,500 people, even smaller Catholic population. They did get the word from the bishop there that they are going to rebuild. So that's a positive sign. But it's going to be a long road to recovery, no doubt.
Well, you always think, where's the money going to come from? You know,
that's
a devastated community can't help itself. So hopefully we'll see some kind of response from people around
the response has been great, and they've got it, like you say, from all over the country. And a lot of it's coming. It's just how do they use those resources now? And that's what they're trying to figure out.
Well, we'll be praying for them, and I hope you'll have an update for us soon.
I will.
Thank you, Mark.